So now, as we have seen the general clinical features of all the three variants, that is of monostotic, polystotic and craniofacial forms, we need to see some of the points or clinical features which are in the interest of monostotic fibrous dysplasia, especially of jaws. Jaws ke jo bhi clinical features hai, we need to see in detail because these are mainly of our concern. Baki jo the, they were of generalized whole body. But these are of our concerns. So firstly, it is more of concern to the dentist because we are going to face so many cases, or whenever we face a case such like this, then we should be able to categorize this disorder. Secondly, there is a word, leonatiasis ossea. Kya hai leonatiasis ossea? Now what does this word mean? It means the face or appearance like a lion or leonite. Whenever the fibrous dysplasia affects the maxilla or any other facial bones, then there will be obviously the enlargement of that bone, slowly growing, painless swelling is the main clinical feature. So there will be the enlargement of that particular bone which is affected. So it will give a typical appearance like a leonite or lion faces. Now that appearance is known as leonatiasis ossea. So this is also an MCQ question. Next, it mainly affects mostly the children and young adults. Males and females are equally affected, but some cases have shown slight predilection towards the females. The mean age of occurrence is considered 34 years. Now, what are the main clinical features? So, it may show painless swelling or bulging of the jaw. It may be maxilla or mandible. If maxilla is more commonly affected than mandible, matlab the cases of maxilla reported till date are more as compared to the mandible. In that also, labial or buccal aspect is more commonly affected and lingual is affected sometimes, right? So maxilla and labial and buccal aspect are affected more. If mandible is affected, then surely the lower border of mandible will also be involved. So there will be slight bulging of the lower border of mandible also. Now lastly, there will be, if you radiographically see, all the appearance or the radiographic appearance are going to be remain the same, that is radiolucent, some fine trabecula or little bit of trabecula are seen, that will give a ground glass appearance or orange peel appearance, or you can also say putty orange appearance. So these are going to remain the same. Sometimes the lesion will also present as a mix, that is some part will show radiolucency and radioopacity with a mixed characteristic also, but there are that are very much rare. Mainly ground glass appearance you have to remember. There will be expansion and distortion of cortical plates, displacement of teeth, or there may also be change in the eruption pattern of the teeth also. Now regarding maxilla, it extends. If maxilla is affected, then it can also extend to the maxillary sinus or zygomatic bone also, and even orbit can also be, orbital or periorbital areas we have seen that they are also affected. And at last, there is going to be a marked facial deformity or facial asymmetry, you can say. So these were some of the points which I need to mention regarding separately of jaws. I hope you guys have understood. Next, moving on to the radiographic, histologic and the treatment of fibrous dysplasia. Firstly, starting with the radiographic features. So in the radiographic features, as we all know, the fashion of disease or the occurrence of disease is mainly through resorption of bone, and that is getting replaced by the fibrous tissue. So it is but obvious that the radiographic features are going to show a radiolucent lesion in the diaphysis or metaphysis of the bone with endoosteal scalloping. Kya dikhegi aapko? Scalloping dikhegi. Then second, there will be rind signs. Now what is rind signs? Now whichever the scalloping you are seen in around the radiolucent lesion, that border is going to appear as a sclerotic border, thick sclerotic border jaisa dikhega. So that sign is known as rind sign. So two things we discuss. First is the radiolucent lesion. This lesion is seen as a radiolucency with a scallop border, and that border is sclerotic, that is known as rind sign. Now this radiolucent appearance is also characterized as an appearance that is known as ground glass appearance. How it is characterized as ground glass appearance, or you can also say as orange peel appearance. Jo bhi radiolucency dikhegi, that will be a bit hazy So that type of radiolucency is characterized as ground glass appearance or orange peel appearance. So this is also an MCQ question or one mark question, that ground glass appearance or radiographically fibrous dysplasia shows which appearance, then ground glass or orange peel appearance. There is also involvement of maxilla and mandible. It may show displacement of teeth, expansion of cortical plates of the bone. The bone is going to get expand slowly in a larger size. So these are all the radiographic features. Now next, discussing about the histological features. So the histological features, the first point is loosely arranged fibrous connective tissue, stroma. क्या लिखा है? Loosely arranged fibrous connective tissue, stroma. Second, मतलब the connective tissue stroma is loosely arranged. Then you'll have irregular trabeculae of the woven bone. Whichever the trabeculae of bone are present, they are irregular, or you can say C-shaped or Chinese letter pattern. And lastly, the bony trabeculae lack the osteoblastic rimming. Whatever the bony trabeculae are present, they are rimmed by osteoblast in normal cases, but in this they lack the osteoblastic rimming around the bony trabeculae. So these are the main three histological features regarding fibrous dysplasia. Treatment, there is usually no such treatment, only conservative treatment can be done to prevent the deformity or any further fractures. If there are any endocrine disorders or any other deformity the patient is facing, then that are to be treated. And at last, surgical bone recontouring is done in severe cases if it is necessary. You can't place any bone graft or something because it is again going to get resorbed. Various bisphosphonates or vitamin D tablets can be given to reduce the pain or enhance the or reduce the resorption of bone or increase the strength of the bone. So this is all about fibrous dysplasia. I hope you guys have understood. If you have any doubt regarding this topic or any other topic, please let us know in the comment section. Thank you.